Yeah, I think there's a lot of opportunities for AI to be applied in the design of cities and infrastructures and buildings and homes. And so at AECOM, we focus on to build, to design, to build, and to operate. So we are currently, it's been a year now, we have been sort of applying AI into different parts of our business. So to design, a year ago, we've developed this design anomaly detector, which is sort of to look for errors and design anomalies with our work. Like many companies, obviously, I think the first step is to apply AI to make ourselves more efficient and to support the design process. And in terms of the build, we are also applying AI into our construction sites, monitoring both safety and efficiency and productivity. And as well as to manage and operate assets and infrastructure, we are currently looking into using AI for different maintenance purposes and operation. But going forward, I think beyond productivity gains and efficiency, I think we're really looking forward to solving the bigger problems in the world. We're an infrastructure firm, as you know, and we're hoping to resolve issues like climate change. So we're actively looking at coastline and redesigning coastlines, equal shorelines, with innovations such as AI and different 3D printing techniques to mitigate the effects of global climate change, as well as urbanization. So we are actively working with different partners, looking at how autonomous vehicles have an impact in the way our cities are planned and built and infrastructure is built around that. So those are the ways that I think we're looking forward to applying AI into what we do. Well, we are, like I said, we're in development with an anomaly detector, we call it DED. We have a second initiative coming out, looking at an AI design assistant to help with our processes. And we're currently looking at an initiative looking at an eco shoreline initiative across Asia Pacific, looking at coastal erosion, looking at rising sea levels, looking at mitigating the effects of tsunami, all that, and the ecology of the sea and coastal areas. So all that is a very complex problem that we think that if we get all engineers together and our architects and our designers with the new technology such as AI and 3D printing, we can help to solve some of these problems.
其实总体来说，我个人是对AI的发展抱持着一个比较乐观的一个态度。对，因为其实我们 从我们 AECOM 的观点来说，其实我们负责非常多的建筑，然后城市规划，甚至景观设计 infrastructure 这样子的案子。那我觉得人类社会和人类的这个 built environment 目前已经复杂到并非人类，我觉得我用人类这个字来表示，就是可以去做一个很好的管理和有效的运用，以及去维持它的一定功能上的运作。 所以其实我觉得，同样的从另外观点来说，其实我们大家像刚才有非常多的这个 speaker 讲到，我们现在面临的是一个全球化的一个人口的下降、人口老化的议题，所以未来我们会越来越少的 resources 可以在管理我们现在生活的一切运作，无论是交通，无论是基础设施，或者甚至我们生活的食衣住行娱乐。那所以我对于 AI 的这个看法来说，我觉得 AI 作为一个 assistant for 人类的这个 human settlement 这样子的一个运作，我其实抱持非常乐观的态度。那因为其实从我的观点来说，有非常多的在建筑管理甚至是城市管理的部分，它有非常多繁杂和可能我说比较琐碎的工作，那它需要 constantly 就是非常持续性的去管理去出错。那这部分的工作其实 在现在的社会越来越少能够找到人可以长期的去从事这样子比较固定式的工作，那它对人的精神来说其实是一种消耗。所以我觉得以 AI 的角色，它能够来 support 人类去做这些管理和这些处理这些比较 routine 的工作，对我来说其实是非常期待的。